This is Andi Purewal for Boxing News. I'm joined by Swedish heavyweight Otto Wallin here in Saudi Arabia. Otto, always a pleasure, my man. How are you?
I'm good, thanks. How are you?
I'm very well, thank you. Obviously, a massive fight week for yourself. How good does it feel to get your teeth into a big fight week like this once again?
It's amazing. It's something I worked for a really long time, so I'm glad that it's finally happening.
Obviously seen some big heavyweight cards brought out here to Saudi Arabia for you yourself, and I know you don't want to look beyond Saturday, but if you win, there's always talk about the life-changing money on offer. Is that on your mind, you know, in terms of how life-changing a win on Saturday could be for you?
Not so much. I just want to win the fight. That's really what I'm focusing on. Focusing on Joshua, focusing on the fight, and whatever happens after, take that then.
We obviously did our interview before the announcement press conference. A few things were said in that press conference which maybe seemed to rile up Anthony Joshua. What is it that you feel that you've done which maybe has gotten underneath his skin?
I don't know. Maybe he doesn't just like me, or he just doesn't like me, or I don't know. I probably said some things that he doesn't like, but, you know, when you get a reaction like that, it just shows that you're right, really, because I feel like I'm just telling the truth. I'm not saying anything to hurt him. It's just I get the questions. I'm going to answer them the way I want to and the way that I see things.
People have kind of questioned Anthony in the past, kind of his mental state, how well prepared he is going into fights. Do you look at him and that word mentally weak has been thrown about? Do you feel like he's in that case?
Well, I think that things are pretty tough for him. He's been at the top. Everybody loved him. He had a really quick career, really made it to the top fast. And then, you know, he's come down, lost to Ruiz, lost to Usyk, and hasn't really looked that brilliant that he was in the beginning when he was knocking everybody out. So I think it's been hard for him, you know, going from everybody loves you to people start criticizing you and this and that. And he's very famous. So, you know, people are critical of him, and that's probably been very hard for him.
When you envisage standing opposite him in the ring on fight night, what goes through your mind? How much have you thought about the fight, how it plays out?
Yeah, just trying to listen to my trainer, think about the game plan, and just remember to enjoy the moment.
What is the game plan?
To win the fight.
obviously, AJ's brought in Ben Davison, somebody you'll be well-versed with. Obviously, he was in the corner for Tyson Fury fight. What have you made of that link-up heading into this bout?
Not much. Ben and Fury was together for some time, and then they had a fight with me, and then Ben was actually fired, so... You know, that's I don't look into that too much. I don't know Ben Davison that well.
So you're the reason he got fired?
Part of it, for sure. You see, after John Fury, after that fight, he was on fire. He was just digging into Ben. I don't know if it was valid or not, but he switched trainers after.
I have to ask Otto, we haven't had it confirmed who's the headline fight, whether it's you and AJ or Wilder Parker. Can you confirm to us if it is just you two headlining?
I thought we were. I haven't heard anything else. I don't know, actually. I hadn't thought about that. But from what I read, I mean, on news, whatever you guys post and that, it seems like we're the headliner. So I don't know.
I have to ask. Obviously, there's all that talk about March 9th. Do you think it's disrespectful, the talk of a potential Joshua Wilder fight, when you two still have to share the ring? Wilder still has to share the ring with Parker?
I don't think about it too much, but I just think it's good for me that he might be thinking about Wilder. He's got to come out, look very good in this fight. So when he does it, he's just got to add more pressure for him. And, I mean, I think it's just crazy to think that they're going to fight on March 9th. It's like 2.5 months from now. There's no way. People should not get any tickets for that fight.
Otto, I appreciate your time now. So I'm sure I'll catch up with you later in the week. Thank you.
Thank you.